All right, hello and welcome to season 1, episode 20 of the Manchester United career mode. If I sound a bit annoyed or a bit just tired, I've just literally finished recording the previous episode. And if you haven't gone and watched the previous episode before you clicked on this, I advise you to go watch it. And you can see why I'm so annoyed. But we are here today with a game against Arsenal. Arsenal are in 4th, we are in 8th. As you can tell by the table, Chelsea did beat us. The result was a similar one we've seen already this season. We saw this result against Man City, and it's exactly the same against Chelsea, except Chelsea were the home team. It was a 5-2 loss against City, and it's a 5-2 loss against Chelsea. We're really struggling against the top six. We've played four of the big six, and only got 1 point out of them. We're on to the final team of that big six. I'm going to be honest with you, straight up, I don't see anything for us in this game. I don't think we're going to get anything. I don't want to admit it, but I just don't. The good thing is, even if we do lose this, we can't fall any lower than 8th. Liverpool have already played their 14th game of the season, and Burnley, even if they do win, will still be a point behind us. So, the positives there. Let's get into the press conference.
Thanks, guys. We're going
to
get
One thing I do know, and I can confirm to you this, De Gea will not be starting anytime soon. He's doing my nothing. Van der Beek would have been part of your plans for today's game. It must be blue to lose him. Honestly, Pogba might do well in his place, but we've got an excellent squad. He's only injured for 4 days. Yeah, he picked up a knock in the Chelsea game. Kai Havertz went blasted through the back of him. Should have been a red card challenge. But what can you do? Struggled to find form so far this season. We can recover. We are underperforming. I'll actually say that. It's more realistic, but we can recover. Pressure and slight run around the game against your rivals, Arsenal. Well, the rivals in more than one form today. We'll play the game, not the occasion. We'll try and actually fucking not play like a bag of shite, but I can't promise anything. Our Chelsea
okay,
performance
guys,
was incredibly
time,
underwhelming. If we get
Thank
another one like that, then
attending.
I think we
Apologies
may be out
we
of top four contention. Top four is looking less and less likely the way we're going. Take a look at the table. Wolves are pissing the league right now. I don't know if they've dropped points. They have. And they haven't played yet, never mind. Spurs in second, City in third, Arsenal complete the top four. We could get back up to... Well, we'll get back up to sixth because of our shoddy goal difference. But, could try and climb the table a little bit. Take a look at the news stories before we head in then. Any November Player of the Month nominees for us? I doubt it. We've been wank. Player of the Month shortlist. Exactly, that's what I thought. We've got Trincao, Ben Yedder, Jesus, and Calvert-Lewin. Wolves, Chelsea, Man City, and Arsenal. Four performing teams right now. We aren't one of those performing teams. Van der Beek's out for 4 days. He'll be back the day after the game, of course, because he liked to time it like that on this game. Arsenal take on Man United. It's a battle between two of the clubs in the pursuing pack as Manchester United host Arsenal in the league. The 3 points look vital to both teams as they attempt to close the gap on the teams above them at the top of the table. Manchester United know that only a win will do for them as they play a catch-up. Arsenal, meanwhile, know that a point would be a bad result, but they'll be chasing victory nonetheless. We should see a positive open game of football. I hope so. Injury crisis worsens for United. Amatai's faced a selection crisis in the weeks ahead after Van der Beek picked up an injury in yesterday's match against Chelsea. That's a problem. But it's a problem we can sort very quickly because, of course, it is only a 4-day injury. Henderson's already in the net, don't worry. I did that at the end of the last episode. Just trying to make sure, though. Right, so look at the team then. We're going to give Laird the run out. I mean, it might be a stupid idea, but we're going to give him the run out. Luke Shaw can stay on. Telles was an awful right back. Maguire, give him a chance. And Varane. McTominay kind of has to play because Fred's injured. Pogba. There's going to be a lot of stamina problems. Fernandez can start. Sancho could have a little break, I think. He just isn't performing in the Premier League. I don't know what's up with him. I kind of want to start Rashford up at striker, but we'll keep it as Ronaldo for now. Rashford will definitely still play, though, because he's been very good so far this season. He's had flashes of brilliance. But I think that's what we roll with for this one. I don't know who the captain. I think it still will be Ronaldo. Yeah. All right. So this is the squad for the Arsenal game. Henderson in between the sticks. Shaw, Laird as a fullbacks. Varane and Maguire as a centre backs. McTominay, CDM. Fernandes and Pogba the centre mids. Alanga left wing. Rashford right wing. And Cristiano Ronaldo up top as the captain and the striker. And hopefully someone who's going to be a key player today. Been a bit invisible recently. It's kind of annoying. As for Arsenal, they've got Leno in goal. Tavares and Cedric as the fullbacks. Gabriel and White as the centre-backs. Gakpo and Saka as the wide midfielders. Xhaka and Sambi Lokonga as the centre midfield. Xhaka, of course, captain in the Gunners. Odegaard in that centre-attacking midfield role. And in that front, they've got Dominic Calvert-Lewin. So Old Trafford hosts Arsenal. Make sure the kits don't clash. They aren't clashing. Good. Sometimes the game decides not to change the kits and it fucks me up. But luckily, it's decided to change them today before I've had to. I'm not even doing this warm-up. I don't care. I'm actually flabbergasted at how bad the Chelsea episode was. And this is going out on the Tuesday, so... I mean, I recorded it on the Monday, but Fall Guys comes out technically today. So, again... might be a lot less. I'll try and keep to the schedule as best I can, but if I fall off the schedule, it's maniac career mode. Blame Fall Guys, alright? Blame Fall Guys. The idea for this career mode in Manchester United is it's supposed to take me up to the end of FIFA. It gives me something to do before FIFA 23 comes out. Whether that stays that way is a different matter. Unless I wasn't going to do the warm-up, but I feel like I need to. See what score I get. All right, Bruno, lock onto the. There we go. Right. What did I get? A B. An A. Lovely.
A head-to-head battle we can quite simply never get enough of. Talk about high profile. This qualifies and a lot more. Stay with us for complete coverage from Old Trafford. It's Manchester United versus Arsenal. And welcome everyone to England's Northwest. The action soon to get underway here at Old Trafford. I'm Derek Ray in the commentary position, and alongside me is the former Arsenal and West Ham midfield player Stuart Robson. I'm very much looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League. It is Manchester United, and they take on Arsenal.
Well, Derek, as is always the case, the team that dominates midfield will be the team that controls the flow of the game. And that, for me, is the area that's key today.
Well, who will be the player to decide the outcome, to determine the course of events? No reason at all why it won't be this man, Stuart. What do you anticipate seeing from him?
Well, that's a very impressive return, isn't it? He's been excellent, and it's not just been his goals. His all-round players look really bright this season.
The lineup for Manchester United. Dean Henderson begins in goal. Harry Maguire plays alongside Rafael Varane in central defence. And leading the line today is Cristiano Ronaldo. And so the starting 11 for Arsenal. Bernd Leno is the goalkeeper. Granit Xhaka plays alongside Martin Odegaard in central midfield. And on this tactical setup, they have just the one player in attack.
Right, well, can only ask for better than what happened in the Chelsea game. Any worse, and I don't really know where to take his team next. We can't lose here, pretty much. We have to win this. We have to get points here against one of the big six. We have to beat one of the big six, surely. So far, it's been a loss against City, a loss against Chelsea, a loss against Liverpool, a draw against Spurs. We've got 1 point out of 12. Of course, we're the other team in the big six, so we can't get any more points after this one. First go around, anyway.
Martin Odegaard. Defeat for Manchester United last time.
Heavy touch, Varane takes advantage of that. What do you expect on this McTominay. Pogba. Well, they were all over the place. Rashford back to Pogba. Ronaldo. Rhythm. Today they can't get there.
More positive attitude. Press the ball higher up the field and show some guile in attack. If they can do all those things, they'll get.
I don't think attack was the problem in that last game, mate. To be honest with you, the attack was fine. Just cutting off the supply. But we made plenty of chances. As usual, the problem is the defence, and we need a world-class centre-back and a world-class goalkeeper next season if we're to push for anything. Pogba. Okay, I've definitely been fouled there, but that's fine. Don't worry about it. Why do we open up like that? Why do we... Oh, my God. We've been let off. Why do we open up like that, though? There's no need for it. Not a time for composure on the ball. I don't know how Arsenal haven't put themselves 1-0 up, to be honest with you. It should be. Paul Pogba's incisive pass. And now it could be us. It could be Ronaldo. It could be Ronaldo. It is. What a change of fortunes. We should be 1-0 down, but instead we're 1-0 up. That's just the luck of the Premier League, isn't it? This is counter-attacking football. I don't think this ball was going to work, to be honest, but Ronaldo connected to it well. I thought Gabriel might shut him down, or is that Ben White? I don't know which one's who. I don't know which one's four and which one's six. It's Ben White, actually, on the defence there. But Ronaldo somehow managed to finish that off. Thank Christ we draw our first blood in this match. We could have been down, and now we're up. Ninth goal. Doesn't feel like he scored that many, to be honest, but ninth goal for Cristiano Ronaldo.
So the game restarted by Arsenal. A wake-up call for the Arsenal players, perhaps. Can they construct a response?
I mean, it's not really a wake-up call. They've been playing really well. They should have had the goal, but we got it instead. I've already got the ball back again. We just have to play really well. That's what I try and do every time, but we need it more than anything today. Rhythm. Oh, rhythm is a dancer. Anthony Elanga. I thought I went over for a second, so that's why I hesitated. But we're not 2-0 up inside 16 minutes. I love this game sometimes. Sometimes I just hate it because we get absolutely destroyed by teams like Chelsea and City. But then you get an Arsenal to come around, get some 3 points off them. I thought this was going over, to be honest with you. I don't know how it's gone there, actually, because I shot it for the right-hand side, but we take it. Rhythm is a dancer. Anthony Elanga, I think that's his first goal in this Premier League season. And he puts his 2-0 to the good here at Old Trafford. And Arsenal maybe losing their confidence a bit. McTominay comes across brilliantly. Pogba. Shouldn't really be running this side. He doesn't have the pace. Ronaldo. Elanga again. Oh, it's becoming a cricket score. We are all over them. What's happening here then? I haven't changed any difficulty. I haven't changed any sliders.
Well, I have to say, this is a really good goal.
We're 3-0 up against Arsenal inside 18 minutes, ladies and gentlemen.
There's no stopping that.
What is happening? Rhythm as a dancer has got two. Maybe he just starts ahead of Sancho from now on. Thoughts? Like, Sancho plays like average. Elanga seems to be making those runs in those spaces, scoring those goals. 3-0. It's 3-0 already. Luke Shaw cuts off Calvert-Lewin from getting through that gap. And we've got the ball back again. Rashi receives it. Let's turn Tavares, can't. Laird. He's trying to catch up to Nuno Tavares here. He's done awfully. As in, Laird's done awfully. Tavares has done brilliantly, but McTominay with the backup there.
Counter-attacking very much an option.
And there was no left back here, and Rashford could take advantage of that.
Ronaldo.
All about to Rashford, turns his man, takes a shot on Leno with a stop, preventing a 4-0 deficit.
Really good defending, you've got to say.
Now, this is what it's like to be doing like this, because I've been on the receiving end of it twice. I thought Shaw would make the run down the line, to be honest with you, but I guess we don't always get what we want.
And they've used it really well today, particularly in the midfield areas, and I expect more of the same as the game goes on.
I mean, oh, Maguire. I thought it was McTominay I was controlling.
Gakpo.
Oh, what about? Okay, I made that more clear. I wanted it to be McTominay. I don't know why Maguire's. Well, Tavares. probably going to get a better of Laird just off sheer experience. Never mind. Oh, Xhaka's cut back. Covered for Tavares there. Laird wins the ball back, though. There's potential in Ethan Laird, definitely. Bruno. Rhythm. He's had a wonderful game so far. Be looking for a hat-trick at some point, but playing for the team just now. Rashford.
It's with McTominay.
Precise ball movement. Ronaldo to Fernandes, tries to take him on, gets tackled.
Racing forward, trying to catch them out.
Been an awful start for Arsenal. We're hoping to try and get it back before it's too late. To get come back into this game. I'm trying to go as Luke Shaw, but of course I'm not allowed. Henderson does brilliantly to shut down Odegaard. How do I justify starting De Gea ahead of Henderson right now? I can't. His answer.
Pogba.
Ronaldo. As well as Sancho and Rhythm, I know I'm starting there for the next while. I know it's going to be a lot of fixtures because it's December, but I know he's getting the majority of the starts. Calvert-Lewin does get one back for Arsenal. I don't quite know what's going on with our defence again. I've got a lot... Like... I'm trying to defend. I am really trying to defend. It's just... Well, it's Man United, isn't it? I don't know what's going on. I don't know why our shape just suddenly disappears. Like, I've got him as I want him and my custom tactics. And suddenly the shape just goes. Calvert-Lewin finishes that off. Fair play, I guess. They don't deserve it, but they've got one. But it's just annoying. I'm just trying to close my blinds. Sorry about that.
So back underway.
Well, they got one back. I don't understand why our defence commits so far forward. I want McTominay to be doing that kind of stuff that Maguire is having to commit forward to. I don't know if to blame McTominay or to blame Maguire. Alanga. I've pressed across. Don't worry about it. Header, and why does the header never go to anyone? I'm aiming for my players with the headers. They just never go to anyone. Laird needs to be watching Tavares here. Of Tavares, I don't even pronounce it. Either way, he needs to be watching his man. Why is it fucking locked me onto Varane? There's no need. There's no need for the game to change my player. I'll do it when I want to, alright? Tavares has done Laird there, but Varane backs up the young right back, Rashford.
So 2 minutes.
Ronaldo, fancy making a run? No, alright, cool. Alanga, you make the run then, because you always seem to make the runs. Rhythm is a dancer, and all that.
Cristiano Ronaldo. Not a particularly strong challenge.
Pogba. Oh, can't get in there. Bruno, it's bounced like a fucking twat, because of course it has, and I'm committing Varane, even though I want to be using McTominay. Heavy pass, it's going to go for a goal kick at half-time, probably. The attacking play isn't a problem. The attacking play is very good. It's a defence that's struggling at the moment. Rhythm as a dancer has had a fucking brilliant game so far. Oh, what's happening, Pogba? He's been having a good game as well. Pogba's been quite good this career mode.
He's worked hard out of possession and he's dictated the flow.
I was considering selling him on after the first season, but if he plays like this, he can have a couple more seasons. We scored 3 in 7 minutes to get a massive lead. Calvert-Lewin gets one back, but we are still controlling the game, in my opinion. Wolves are winning again. Can they just stop? Like, it's gonna be they're gonna be the next Leicester at this rate. 56-44 in terms of possession. 4 shots to 2. 2 expected goals to 1.1. We're in control. Just try and win this, boys. Let's not fuck it up. We've got Palace next. 3 days' time. It's going to be a lot of swapping and changing for this lineup, I think. With the injuries we have, it's not helpful, but luckily Van de Beek is only just a few days. He'll be back.
Bruno Fernandes has it.
Just we had either Wan-Bissaka or Diogo Dalot to get through this spell, but we don't. Alanga into Ronaldo. Not a great challenge for Gabriel, is it? It could be a booking for the Brazilian.
And that is going
exactly
to
what it is. Gabriel.
The referee is absolutely right. He knew what he was doing there.
Yeah, nothing of the ball. All of Ronaldo. Ronaldo touched it ahead of him, trying to get a bit of space, and Gabriel's brought him down. This isn't. I know they've set it up as if I'm going to shoot it. I'm not. I'll tell you firsthand. Unless it's less than 30 yards, which I don't think it is. I'm not, if it's like, I think it's 33. I'm not going to shoot it from here. Yeah. Tomine, where are you going?
Tomine, and return to Ronaldo.
Rhythm. Off to McTominay.
United keep it.
Ronaldo. Back to Rhythm. Ah. Pogba. Rashi. Into Rhythm. Ah. I'm not trying to get it to Rhythm on purpose, by the way. I'm just trying to get anyone there, and he just needs to be in the right positions. Alanga loses out.
Well, we always enjoy bringing you live action on EA TV and Premier League action coming up. It's Manchester United facing Crystal Palace.
Where the fuck is Luke Shaw? Between two entertaining teams in a great stadium. Good catch, Henderson. Where the fuck is Luke Shaw there in that whole situation? Bruno to McTominay.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Rashford asking for it. He's got the pace over Tavares. Oh, it's not Tavares. It's Gakpo. Maybe not then. I don't know how fast Gakpo is. I didn't realize Gakpo was playing left back and Tavares is playing left wing. No, I missed a memo where they swapped.
Gakpo. And that will be the keeper's ball.
That's straight into the hands of Hendo. No worries. No worries. Right, come on, guys. Try to get a fourth. You're right. Just really tips one outside. Don't concede anymore, is my point. Then again, Bruno will just have a touch. That's not Bruno's fault. The touch has fucked him there.
Martin Ødegaard. With a textbook interception.
What's going on? Oh my god. I was about to have a fucking... Oh my god, I was about to have an aneurysm. Not only did the defence just open up again, but like, I wanted Henderson to gather that up, and then Varane just cleared it instead. I'm confused. Oh my god, pass is not working. We're falling apart. Falling apart. Not used to this winning position this long. Kai Osaka. We're taking Luke Shaw, Cedric. Oh my fucking days. They're going to prime Barcelona us now and get the comeback, aren't they?
Cedric.
Yeah, bullies. Just pretend you didn't hit Sisaka there, Maguire. It's like Chiellini did in the Euros.
A good and fair challenge.
Good tackling in the end. Oh!
Gives it a go.
This game is ridiculous. I do one little pass, and apparently it's the hardest pass to receive in the world. It's fallen to Xhaka. I knew it was going to do that, kind of sub-level, so I tried to bring Maguire across. Henderson's got a save on it. Oh, this game is so predictable when they're going to fuck you over now. I've played this too many times now. We should probably make some changes as well, actually. Cedric's going to come off for... I don't even know what number 17 is. Tierney? I don't even know the numbers at Arsenal. But what we're going to do is we're going to freshen up a little bit. Alanga's not coming off. He's been good. Rashford can have a break. We need him as well. Lindelof. Well, actually... Wait, can we put Lindelof centre defensive mid? Do you think he would do... You know, put Lindelof here. See how he does. He might be all right. We need to keep McTominay as fresh as we can because he's the only CDM at the moment. Okay. I don't know who they brought on, but sure. McTominay and Rashford. Sancho and Lindelof. I'm going to try him in that CDM role. It might work out, to be honest. He's got good defending stats.
Corner kick played in.
Ronaldo, right, that's not right, is it though, so, Sancho's on, fresh, do we need a runner, Pogba is said runner, Sancho, takes his man on, oh, it's just bad luck for him on that occasion, free kick how? I don't know how it's Arsenal free kick, but Sancho nearly making it four just as he came on the pitch. Maguire. Bruno, what a tackle.
Bruno Fernandes. Ronaldo!
It's like clockwork. It's like clockwork. Double figures now for the GOAT. We're 4-1 up. Ronaldo could come off now, I think. Rest him up for the Palace game. In fact, we might as well start Cavani or Rashford up top for the Palace game.
Well, here you can see it again. Good run, great strength, and a composed finish under pressure. That's a
great finish. 4-1. I don't know if we'd score any more other than those three in the that 7-minute gap in the first half, but Cristiano Ronaldo gets himself a brace and he's going to have a break as well. We're going to give him a rest for this one. Pogba's looking tired, but either Pogba or Bruno can have the rest next game because Bruno, because Donny's back. We can maybe whack in Mata if we absolutely need to. Four-one United. This is more of what I want to see. The defence has still been suspect, but the attack has been world class, and we've actually managed to finish our chances today. We just have to outscore them this season, I think. Work on the defence probably next season. Double figures for the goat. Pogba launches it to Fernandes. I said launches, it was a tap along the floor to Fernandes. Lindelof. Ah, tried to pick out Ronaldo. Not Ronaldo, Cavani now. Cavani's on. Come on, use your broom. Good roll for Henderson. Arsenal have had chances to make chances, if that makes sense. Like, they've had the opportunity, but just haven't been able to create anything.
And it wasn't a great pass,
oh, rhythm. You've had such a good game, man. What's going on?
Calvert-Lewin. And on to Xhaka. Now they've lost it.
I think Calvert-Lewin might have been offside, but Varane gets in the way anyway.
And the counter looks on here.
Jane Sancho.
Cavani.
Vani. Alanga.
Well, tremendous block.
I'd love for him to get his hat trick, but fucking one of my team has blocked it. Cavani. Lindelof. Sancho, Sancho tried to nip it through to Alanga. Cavani instead.
Lindelof now. Can he put it away?
He deserves a hat-trick, to be honest. I'm going to be kind of annoyed if I don't get it with him. I am trying to get it with him now, just exclusively, because we're 4-1 up. But just for the record. I don't think it'll happen, but I would like him to get it.
Deciding to go inside.
Ref. I should keep playing, keep playing, keep playing. Oh, ref, bring it back.
It's a good-looking ball in behind.
Maguire gets in the way. I don't know if he knew much about it, but he got in the way anyway. Right, rhythm's not making a run, so play it through this way. Now he's making said run. Those runs he made in the first half have got him the goals. Oh, fucking hell. Yeah, I'm trying with him, but I don't think it's going to happen. That being said, I'll probably still call this with him as a dancer this episode. Lang has been very good. Gakpo, try to get another one back for Arsenal. Dribbled off the pitch. Yellow card for Desquilio.
And
a late substitution. Calvert-Lewin coming off for, I believe, Lacazette. Yeah. Yeah. Poor Lacazette. It's not going to get an impact on the game. That being said, they're probably intercept my throw in and go and score with Lacazette. So.
Pressing high. And they have the ball again. And there it is, the final whistle.
That's fucking hilarious. That's fucking hilarious. I knew exactly what the game was going to do. And even though it didn't count, Lacazette still scored. I'm trying to go as Varane there to come across. And it just doesn't let me. It just doesn't want me to. I knew that was going to happen as well. I said it. This game's too predictable. 4-1 victory though. The golden cap because the ref blew whistle beforehand.
Well, he did everything today. His energy,
brace from Ronaldo, brace from rhythm.
Good for those defenders. It was a really good display.
4-2 victory. Or 4-1 victory, sorry. At Old Trafford. Something we really fucking needed. Especially against one of the big six.
Ronaldo.
So I ain't opposed, to be honest, with that one. Ronaldo 2, Alanga 2, Calvert-Lewin got one as well. Take a look at the stats, we deserved it. 54-46 in terms of possession, 8 shots to 4, 3.8 expected goals to 1.7. Yeah, winning is always ours. And Hendo only conceded 1, so he'll be staying in between sticks, I think. Man of the match goes to Cristiano Ronaldo, 2 goals and an assist. He got the 9.3 rating, but full credit to Anthony Elanga. Comes on, starts with Sancho, gets two goals. Jaden, mate, your start spot may be in trouble. Bruno Fernandes come in with two assists as well and an 8.1 rating, and Pogba with the other assist, 7.6. He's playing solidly this career mode as well. Varane and Henderson doing very well, too. I didn't check the Arsenal ratings. There's not really any need to, because I already know it's going to be, by default, Calvert-Lewin, but no one else really played well. So Calvert-Lewin getting a 7.4 rating because he got the goal, like I said. Bukayo Saka with the assist and a 6.3. I'll see what his rating is just now. He's 82. He's already growing. Starts at an 80. Jesus Christ. Odegaard as well. Another one we need to keep an eye on. Maybe keep an eye on both those players to sign him in the future. Post-match interview. A big win. A needed win. A much looked after, sought after win. So, get me this straight. We beat Watford 4-1. We lose to Chelsea 5-2. And then Watford beat Chelsea.
Just a moment of your time.
Can't figure that one out myself, but I never was the smartest. I mean, long term, Van der Beek is back next game. We'll look at him back when he's ready. He'll be back for the Palace game, so there's no worries there. Should we talk about the lads who played today? They're excellent. Yep. Rhythm is a dancer, playing world class. Have asked some more from him today. Maybe I wish I'd got my hat trick. He deserved the hat trick, but not to be, unfortunately. And forwards here, fans will remember for a long time, hopefully. Massive 4-1 win. We did just lose 5-2 before that. We took our chances, and that was the difference. They had chances, couldn't put them away. We had chances and put them away. We could have had 5, but Sancho unfortunately hit the
Thanks
post.
So much for
he needed to
questions.
Score that for his morale. I'm genuinely, if he's got the fitness, I'm genuinely debating on starting Rhythm again. We've got some monthly scout reports. We've got two scouts now because we need to get some more players in as backup, the ones that keep getting injured. So we've got a Ireland report from Valerie Maximov. Neil Malone looks good out of the gate. James Kavanagh. I should be reading their stats out as well, shouldn't I? Overall, 44 to 62. Potential is 63 to 87. We'll take a chance on him. Dare Driscoll. Overall, 37 to 53, potential 46 to 64. Not even close to making the cut. Sean Morrow, 47 to 63 overall, 74 to 94 potential. We'll give him a chance, see how his potential comes up. Ian Curry, 43 to 59 overall, 59 to 81 potential. Sorry, lad, you don't make the cut. And Liam Cairns, 39 to 55 overall, 49 to 67 potential. He will not be signing for us. Then we've got our usual England one from Elliot Winter. Ruben Waite. He looks decent. He's asking quite a bit for a wage. Well, you're good at something. You're special. Overall, 50 to 66. Potential 70 to 94. We will take a chance on him, but he's asking for a lot of money. Elliot Dixon, 41 to 55 overall. 61 to 83 potential. He will not be joining, unfortunately. And he's asking for an astronomical wage so he can whistle. Theo Willis, 42 to 58 overall. 63 to 87 potential. Unfortunately, not for us. Alex Butcher. 42 to 58 overall, 67 to 91 potential. He won't be coming in, unfortunately. He's overall just not good enough. Realistically, though, this is a man I'm hoping is going to be good next one. Ah, what a letdown, man. Teddy Smythe, I thought he was going to be good. Overall looks good, 54 to 72, and if his overall is good, I'll give him a chance. His value even is good, I'll give him a chance. But his potential is only 61 to 81, so we'll see what his overall is. I'm gonna take a chance on him. Now Sebastian Curtis. Overall 45 to 59, potential 76 to 94. We'll give him a bit of time. We need people, so we'll give him a bit of time. You promised me I'd get a game right now, I need minutes on the pitch. You can have the next one. You can have Palace, like. You're not very good though, Mata, quite frankly. And even though like you're a legend, you're just not great anymore, if that makes sense. I don't know if it does. I don't care. Makes sense to me. Donny van der Beek is coming with a message. Feel much better in myself. Ready to play. Hope you can get me back in the team. You're a big player for us. You probably will start. Give you a chance anyway. yeah, that's it for this episode. Let's take a look at the table after 14 games. Give a quick little update. We're in sixth currently. Good win over Arsenal, who stay in fourth, but we've slowed their progress down. Wolves, still a point off, still a point clear, I should say, at the top. 10 wins, 2 draws, 2 losses. They're on top of all this season, it looks like. Spurs in second, point off the top. Manchester City in third, Arsenal fourth. Chelsea fifth, we're sixth. We're back in the race a little bit. We're only a point off now, thanks to that win over Arsenal. Reading down, as you can see, Liverpool still underperforming. And in the relegation zone is Watford, Brighton and Southampton still. Southampton back to the foot of the table. Newcastle, I thought, would be doing better with their team, but didn't expect much more. Norwich. Did we see who November Player of the Month was? It's not going to be me. I already know that, or any of my players. It hasn't been announced yet. We'll find out after the Palace game, I suppose. But anyway, that is going to end this episode of the Manchester United Career Mode. We've got a hell of a month coming up for this week. So Wednesday will be Palace. Thursday will be Atalanta. Friday will be Norwich. Double upload for Saturday will be Brentford and Brighton. Double upload for Sunday will be Newcastle and Burnley. And then for next week, we take on the league leaders. I don't know if they'll be the league leaders by then, but they're the league leaders now. We take them on in January, and that will kick off next Monday. Then Tuesday, Villa. Wednesday, West Ham. We'll go through all the transfer window as well. We're not going to be signing people. We may sell people, or I don't know really yet what's going to happen with the January window. I'm not really too fussed about it. We still haven't got our FA Cup game yet either, so that will be happening. Surely that's happening soon, right? I'm going to take a little look at the bracket. If we get City again in the FA Cup after we had them in the Carabao Cup, I'm going to be throwing hands at the developers. What round are we on currently? Round 2. Alright, these are still yet to be played. Some have been played. Some are yet to be played. Once these are played, we'll know our next... we'll know our first FA Cup fixture in this career mode. But anyway, that is going to end it, like I said. A nice 4-1 win. That is a good cleanser after losing 5-2 to Chelsea. But we still need to try and get some consistency if we want to try and get top 4. Because currently we're a point off it. But if we start losing games a lot more again, we'll fall off again. So it's just going to be a matter of trying to, you know, stay consistent. But that is going to be it for episode 20. Like I said, all you guys have enjoyed. And I will see you when we take on Crystal Palace at Old Trafford.